I'm in Geometry Sketchpad. You can see I've got the function p of x written up here, and I have my zeros labeled at negative 1, positive 1, and 4. First thing I'm going to do is find out where the y-intercept is. So in order to do that, I'm going to substitute the value of x equals 0 into our function. So let's go to number and calculate 0 subtract 1 times 0 plus 1 times 0 subtract 4 quantity squared. I can see that my answer equals negative 16 is already there. So I can go ahead and plot that point. 0, negative 16. So it appears that between these two zeros, function is negative. It will go down here to negative 16 and back up to this zero. Not positive that this is minimum or a relative minimum until I look at some other values in between here, a negative a half and positive a half. But it does look that this function will go down to here and up to this. Between those two zeros, this area is negative. So now let's see what happens to the left of negative 1. So let's pick a value, say negative 5, and substitute it into p of x. So we go to number again, calculate. I can use these brackets here and these numbers, negative 5 subtract 1 bracket times, I prefer to use on my keyboard, negative 5 plus 1, but I do have to use these time signs. Negative 5 subtract 4, quantity squared equals. You can see the answer, 1,944. So we can determine from that, from this zero, the end behavior is very quickly going towards positive infinity. So on this side, going to be positive, and we can see it gets to be positive pretty quickly. So I can sketch that the function is going to be coming up here. Now I have to determine in between these two zeros. So let's pick the point x equal 2 and substitute it in and find out what the value of p of x is. So 2 minus 1 times 2 plus 1 times 2 minus 4 quantity squared, and our answer is 12. So you can see that in between here the function has positive values. I could substitute another point, substitute x value of 3 to verify that. Let's graph 2, 12. So we can see that the function from the 0 and 1, don't want to do that. So from this, just want to get off of those, so let's try that again. From this 0 here, goes up to this point, might not be a relative maximum, and back down here again. So between these two zeros, it looks like we have a maximum value there, a relative maximum, because we can see this goes to positive infinity over here. One last area to check, that's to this side of our 0 of 4. So again, let's substitute in positive 5 and calculate our function. 5 minus 1 quantity times 5 plus 1 times 5 minus 4 squared, and our value is 24. So again, we can see on this side of the 0, 4, the function tends to positive infinity. Well, I can draw it coming like this. So there we have a relatively good sketch. A little shaky, but have a great idea of what our function of p of x will look like.